notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see complete exam analysis of UPSC Prelims Paper 1 2020. Make sure you watch this video till the end because this video is going to provide you complete analysis including cutoff. Okay, so now let's begin this video without any delay. First, let's see what are exam highlights. Okay, paper 1 timings is 9:30 to 11:30 and paper 2 timings is 2:30 to 4:30. Just now students have completed their paper 1, which is from 9:30 to 11:30 a.m. So now let's see what are the exam highlights. Okay, coming to the exam highlights, exam mode is offline and type of questions are objective. Objective types of questions were asked and duration of exam is 2 hours. Okay, so completely there will be 2 hours of duration for this particular exam, and there is also negative marking for this exam. For each and every wrong answer, 1/3 of the mark will be deducted. Qualifying marks are 33%. Student, that is candidate, must get at least 33% of marks on in each paper. Coming to the students' reaction, students told the paper is a bit difficult and few students told paper is at the moderate level. So today's, according to students, according to candidates who gave today's exam, the difficulty level of the paper is between moderate to bit hard. Okay, bit difficult. So now let's see section. So now let's see what all topics were covered in today's exam and what is the difficulty level of those sections, of those topics. Okay, come to the exam. Questions were asked from current affairs, history, geography, politics, economics and science and technology. All these topics were covered in today's exam. So coming to the current affairs, so the candidates told few questions from current affairs were very difficult and they were unable to solve them. There were like 4 to 5 kind of questions. There were around 4 to 5 questions which candidates felt very difficult, and the difficulty level of current affairs is in the between of moderate to difficult. Okay, few students told current affairs difficulty level is moderate, they are able to attempt it, and few students told it's extremely difficult and especially 4 to 5 questions they are unable to attempt them. Okay, next is history. Coming to the history, most of the few questions were asked from ancient history and also from civilizations. All these topics were covered under today's history exam, and the level of history is difficult. Okay, most of the candidates told the history is very difficult compared to other subjects. Next is geography. Coming to geography, the questions were covered under, few questions were covered under ecology, environment, etc. And the level of geography is in between the level of moderate to difficult. Okay, so coming to the geography, students told 2 to 3 unexpected questions were asked in today's exam. So coming to next is politics. Coming to politics, questions were asked from Indian politics as it is very important. And next is they have also asked about the government, questions related to government and laws. So students who are going to attempt this exam in future have to concentrate on these specific topics. And coming to politics, the difficulty 2 to 3 unexpected questions were asked, where students didn't take the risk of attempting them because we all know there is 1/3 of negative marking for each and every wrong answer. So few questions, few candidates told they have left a few questions without attempting, unattempted. Okay, and the difficulty level of politics is difficult because few candidates told compared to the previous year, this year politics paper was bit difficult and unexpected questions were also asked. So next is economics. Coming to economics, as usual, they have asked questions from India economy and social development. So this is very important topic. Coming to economics, the difficulty level of this paper is in between moderate to difficult. Only few students told that this paper is moderate, and most of the students told the paper was very difficult. Okay, so next is science and technology. Various fields were covered under science and technology, and this particular section is difficult. So students mostly need to concentrate on science and technology, politics, history and current affairs, as these sections were very difficult in today's exam. And compared to previous year, that is compared to 2019 year, today's paper was bit hard. Few students were telling today's paper is at the is bit hard at level. And coming to history, questions were covered from art and culture, ancient history and also modern history. Coming to politics, questions were covered from right issues and different kind of rights, constitution, etc. Few questions from science and technology are logical questions, are tricky questions. Students told they had to read questions at least 2 to 3 times in order to understand the question properly. So few questions from science and technology are logical and indirectly asked. So now let's see what is the cutoff for UPSC prelims 2020 paper 1. Okay, UPSC prelims 2020. Okay, so coming to general category, at least you must get 98 plus marks. Okay, 97, 98 plus marks you need to get in order to qualify this particular exam. Okay, so for general, cutoff is going to be about 98. And coming to EWS, students, that is candidates, must get at least 79 to 80 plus marks. Okay, so coming to OBC, students must get 95 plus marks. And coming to SC, students must get 82 plus marks. 82 plus marks. Okay, so coming to ST, students must get 76 plus marks. Okay, and coming to PWBD, students must get minimum 52 plus marks. I am also going to make a video on what questions were asked in today's UPSC prelims exam. Answers for those questions, all these things I am going to cover in other video and release it in next 2 hours. If you want to get that video notification, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends so that they'll also understand the exam analysis of today's exam. Support our channel, like and share. Don't forget to like and share. That's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And if you have any queries or if you wanted to know anything more, if you wanted to know anything more about today's exam, don't forget to let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching and all the very best for your career.